So we are the Black Lives Matter at MHS, and we're gonna be talking about microaggressions. So one microaggression that comes up basically daily for me, I don't know for everybody else, is oh, can I touch your hair? And I'm not in the cutting zone, or I'm not an animal. So just because my hair looks different than yours, I don't want everyone to ask oh, can I touch your hair?
Another microaggression is assuming that all of the colored students are in the MECO program. For one, yes, I am, but for example, she's not. When we go and get a pass from a teacher or something, they right away write down MECO, but they don't ask. And then when you're I'm not in MECO, and then they're I'm sorry, I just assume this is it's okay. It's not okay, but it's just ask, because it's not that way.
So I usually experience microaggressions, usually in class. And one of the most recent was me in history class, and we were talking about the first Black man who went to the White House to have dinner and as a servant. And so the girl sitting next to me, while the teacher was presenting, and she said, "Oh, I thought that was you." As in a joke, but it wasn't really a joke. I didn't find it funny at all. I was how do you think that's me? That doesn't make any sense. And I just kept on thinking about it, and it really is a microaggression. Even if she thought it was a joke and she was laughing about it.
And another microaggression that has actually happened to me, a girl came up to me one time. She was just I just want to ask you a question. And I was okay. She was what do you live in? Do you live in an apartment or a house? So I live in a house. I don't live in an apartment. And no, I do not live in the ghetto or whatever. And back to microaggressions about hair, yes. Actually, some guy was okay, I had my hair in an afro, but he was okay, can I toss my pencil in your hair? And I was no. So, I don't know what else anybody else wants to say.
Yeah, anything?
Okay.
Something that happened to us. So we made posters for the Black Lives Matter poster in the cafeteria, and someone posted up a thing that said Blue Lives Matter, and that was so annoying. I mean, you have the right to your own opinion or whatever, but it was right on our poster. Not on our poster, it was right next to our poster. And it got to us.
It was pretty much for me, I was wow, you guys didn't feel this way until we decided to put up our Black Lives Matter stuff. But it's if you did feel this way, why wouldn't you just bring up the issue to us instead of, trying to battle and go back and forth with whose lives matter, whose life doesn't matter? It's just if we're supposed to be a tight-knit group within the school and within the community or whatever, why would you feel the need to just go against something that one person has to say? Why can't you honestly be open to opinions and stuff?
Me and my friend Michaela, we're walking to ASL, and there's this guy who had a sign on his shirt that said, "I don't think Black Lives Matter is the answer." I was I don't think the sign on your shirt is the answer either. So I'm calling the line.
But yeah, these are usually just microaggressions that we experience throughout the school day, throughout the school year. And some stuff we just want you guys to know is that don't try to make little jokes about race and about stuff in history class, because even if you may not know it's racist, just don't say it at all, because it could really affect someone.
Well, for me,
I'm sorry. But Yeah, but I'm actually glad that some of this stuff does happen because it allows me, for one, to be open and to actually speak up on how I feel when people before me probably weren't able to, and they probably were arrested and beaten and all that because they wanted to say how they felt. So it makes me feel better that I'm able to speak out within the school, within the community, and to be able to tell them how I feel about my life.